God. Receive her.
Does anybody want the Lord to make them better? I know I do. And if it takes all the worldly things from my life, make me better, Lord.
Please make
me better. And if it means that I have a lot to sacrifice, make me better, Lord.
Please
yes, make me better. Even if it means sometimes I have to fight with tear-stained eyes, make me better, Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Even if it means sometimes that I fall to when I try, I get up and go on. If you make me strong, yeah. Because I want to give you my best, and I'd only be hurting myself if I try to give you less. Sometimes that the road will get rough, make me better, Lord.
Please make me better.
I'll go on just knowing that your grace will be enough to make me better, Lord. Yeah, yeah. All because I want to give you my. If I try to give you less, listen, I want to be better than good enough. Cause just being good won't be quite enough. Lord, make me ready to stand my test. I want to be better, Lord, to do my best. So make me better. Hey, Lord, I'm willing to pay the price. Yes, I'm willing to sacrifice.
Of trying to be what he thinks that he ought to be. So many of you have gone to school and gotten your intellectual self all built up and you have gotten all kinds of degrees and certificates on your wall. But you know what happened? It didn't make you who you supposed to be. You got in pride. Oh, most people that have all kinds of degrees and certificates are as proud as peacocks. That's how you know that I'm not going against education. Education is good, but it is not sufficient to make you who you are. That's why many of you, you have it, but you're not happy about it. Oh, but I tell you, if you ever get hooked up to the knowledge of God, that means that every other thing that you do, you will take it and place it within the leaves of God's tree. And when he gets through wrapping his arms around it, it'll take you to a victorious place. Many of you have wasted years doing something that you don't like. God said, I have sent my son so that you may have the abundant life. And abundant life does not involve, oh, I hate going to this job. Oh, it's Monday morning, blue Monday. You have not found the secret to life. When you really know what life is all about, and when you really start living it according to God's definition, you don't have no blue Mondays. The only days that you have are like Calvin Bridges say, I've had some good days, but you don't have no other kind. Why? Because even if negativity comes in your life, you know that God is right there with you, so that negativity will be turned around into a positive experience. Listen, I gotta move quickly, but I want you to know that God told me to tell you it's some things that you need to know about him. God is so far different than who you think he is. God is so much greater than what you think he is. You know, one of my most favorite verses that God told me is wrong with the human race. We are so busy trying to compare God to ourselves because we know that we will cheat. We think God will cheat us, because we know that we will retaliate. We think that God will retaliate against us, because we are the kind of people that will take back our love if somebody displeases us. And you know that you are displeasing God every day. So consequently, you never believe in the love of God that has been given unto us, so that we may walk through this life, be totally victorious, and wind up in the presence of God for eternity. Listen, you must stop taking man's thoughts, stop taking man's ideas, stop believing what man has to say. Do you know 90% of the preachers don't know God themselves?